All right, so I'm going to show you how to track out your beats from the MPC into Ableton Live. Now, you can do this with any other DAW because I'm going to show you how to use it with MIDI cables. I mean, there's other ways to do it, and I'll explain why I'm using MIDI in this video. But once you do your beats, you want to track them out. You want to mix them into your DAW, so that's the best thing to do. I mean, you can sequence them with the MPC, but the best thing is to just track it out and then do your mixing from there. So all right, let's get into it. I'm going to show you first how to hook everything up. All right, so what you want to do is you want to get a MIDI cable like this. Okay, this is a standard 5-pin MIDI cable. All right, and all you do is you hook this up to the MIDI in and MIDI out of the MPC, all right? And then you hook it up to your sound card. But what you do is, what I do is I go from MIDI in 1 to the MIDI out of the sound card. All right, so I mean that's what might be confusing to some people if they're not used to MIDI. Is basically you go in and out, so you're going out of your sound card into the MPC, then you go out of the MPC into your sound card. You get it? All right. So what I have is, I'm going out of my sound card, MIDI out, to MIDI in 1 of the MPC. Then I go MIDI out A of the MPC to MIDI in of my sound card. Now, it depends what kind of sound card you have. I have the Audio 8 DJ from Native Instruments, but it's pretty standard. You just go in and out, okay? Now, with the 2500, you got 4 MIDI outs, you got 2 MIDI ins, but those are the ones I use. So I use 1 and A, all right? Now, what that's going to do is it's going to allow Ableton to control the MPC. Now, you can also control the MPC with Ableton. I'm not going to show you that in this video. This is all about using Ableton to control the MPC, to play it, and to record your tracks into Ableton. All right. Now, the thing is that this is just the MIDI. Now, the MIDI cables, all it's doing is that it's just controlling it. So all the MIDI cables are doing are just controlling the MPC. But the thing is, how do you get the sound from the MPC? All right. So it's the MIDI cables control it. Where does the sound come from? It comes from over here. All right. I've got mine with the stereo quarter inch out. Okay, it's going out of here into my mixer, which is actually hooked up to my sound card. It could just go right into your sound card, let's say. So me, I have a mixer as well. So let's say, for example, this is going straight to your sound card, which is hooked up to your computer. And that is where the sound is coming from, out of your MPC into Ableton. All right, so the MIDI controls the MPC. The audio cables bring the sound out of the MPC into Ableton. So it's very simple. Okay, you got the quarter inch plugs here. And I mean, you got the 8 outs here on the 2500. All right, so you might be doing it that way. I don't know. I'm using the stereo out. All right, so that's it for the setup. All right, so now that your MIDI cables are hooked up properly, the ins and outs, all right, what you want to do is load up a project on the MPC. All right, so right here, I have just some drums set up. I'm going to play them. All right, so just some basic drums, that's it. So what I do now with this is you go in the MPC, you press mode, and then you go to pad 9. Then you're going to get to this screen. It says MIDI and then sync. So you just leave all this, you go to sync. Okay, sync on. Sync in. To 1 slave. This is what you want. What you see on the screen, that's what you want to have. The slave, and then you want to have the mode is MIDI clock, and MMC is on. All right, so that's what you want to do. Then you can go back to your main screen. So now, what I can do is still press the play on the MPC. All right. Okay, but what I want to do is I want to do it with Ableton. So here I got the play button here in Ableton. See, I press play and it's controlling the MPC. All right, now how do I do that? Now, the first thing you want to do before you actually start playing with stuff is set your tempo. Okay, 98 BPM, it's the same as the MPC, right? It's got 98, so there you go. Because otherwise, it'll play according to what BPM you have in Ableton. So make sure that's set up. All right, so for me, you go to the MIDI setting here. So for me, I have it set up like this here. These are the settings you want. Okay, this is my sound card here, the Audio 8 DJ. I've got track on. This is the delay. I didn't touch that. The sync type, you want MIDI clock. I did see one article somewhere where they mentioned MIDI timecode, but that didn't, I don't know, didn't work for me. So I'm going with MIDI clock, and I put this, the frame rate at 25. Then I have the clock type. This is the important part here, because I noticed a problem here, right? Now look, there's song and pattern. When I clicked on song and I press play here, it works, all right? It triggers the MPC. The thing is though, now you look at the MPC here, and I've got the loop on, all right? I just turn the loop off now. Now check it out. See, it's playing in Ableton, but it's not triggering the MPC. I don't know why it does that. I have no clue. So I figured if I want to do loop off, because let's say you have a track that you want to just record, like, you know, just, it's not just like, let's say a 2 or 4 bar loop or whatever. You just want to record all the way through. You got to go to pattern. Once I go to pattern, plus loop off on the MPC, now it works. Now I put loop on and it works. So go with pattern. I mean, if you're just playing with loops, you can go with song. I don't know what the difference is with Ableton with this setting here, but I'm just going to keep it a pattern. So check this screenshot here. These are the settings that I use. They should work for you. This is from various tutorials I looked up and just from playing around. This is what I came up with. So this is my Ableton. And there you go. That's it. It just triggers it, and there you go. And I just track it out. What I do though is I'll track out, like right here, I've got audio, but I've got these set up here, kick, snare, hat. Okay, this is my drum group. So I'll record, for example, let's go to track mute here. Okay, I've got my drums. I've got the other stuff muted out already, but for my drums, I just got that highlighted. Let's go to pad mute. So what I'll do is, let's see here. I'll mute my snare and hat, and then, so let's go back here. I'll select my kick. So now I want to record just my kick, all right? So I've got it all set up. It's ready to go. I'll start recording just the kick. Just like that. Then I'll go to the next one, the snare. Then I'll mute the kick, highlight the snare, do the same thing. And that's it. And I just keep going for every group, sound, every pad that I need to or whatever. So, I mean, there are some, like, for example, these keys. Let me mute the drums. I'll go with the keys here. Let's listen to it just with the keys. All right. So that's my keys right there. If you go to pad mute, I've got six pads here for the keys. So for me, I won't separate them all. I'll just keep all those as one track. Okay, those are just the pads out. So I don't do that for that. For the drums, I separate them, but not for the other instruments. I'll leave it like that. So, all right. So one thing I need to mention is that I record my beats from the MPC into Ableton, but just I pretty much do about four or eight bar loops. All right, and the reason why is because one of the issues that apparently happens. I don't know. It hasn't happened to me because I haven't tried it. But apparently is that if you go on for a long period recording, it goes out of sync. So I don't know why it does that. Apparently it does. So I don't know if it's Ableton or if it's sound card or if it's the MIDI from the MPC. I don't know. But apparently it does. So the thing is that what I do is, like, for example, this beat. Okay, I've got a 4-bar loop. All right. This is what I've recorded from my MPC. It's 4 bars. You can see up here, it's 4 bars. All right. Now, the thing is that I could have recorded it and just kept going all the way through. If I do that, then it would probably, you know, after, let's say, a minute, for example, it might just all of a sudden go out of sync. All right. And the thing is, I understand some people want to use the MPC to sequence their beats because it's a very good sequencer. However, if you do that, it's just that it takes a long time because let's say you have, I don't know, let's say you have 5 tracks on your MPC. And let's say your song, you know, your whole sequence, your whole song is about 4 minutes. So that's going to take you about 20 minutes to track out every track altogether. So instead, what I do is I'll take, let's say, a 4-bar loop and I'll just record, you know, this track. Then I'll do this track, then this one, for example. I'll keep doing it like that. And it only takes me a couple minutes to do all this. And then from there, then I'll just copy all this. And then I'll copy it over to here. Then here and here and so on and so forth. And then I can do my editing. See, like here I took out part of the kick and snare and the hat and all that stuff. So I prefer doing this way because to me it's a hell of a lot faster than just trying to sequence out, you know, the whole song from the MPC. I mean, some people do like doing that. But I just think this is a lot faster to do it in the DAW. To me, it just makes it the workflow much, much faster. Now, the thing is, apparently, some people have also that want to do it that way, the long way, is they'll save their MPC sequence as a MIDI sequence, then they'll import it into their DAW. Now, I have not done that yet. I don't plan on doing it because, like I said, I don't see the point to it. I mean, I think it's just better to just mix this way. But some people do that. So look that up because apparently that's a thing that some people do. But this is the way I do it. So I'll just record 4 or 8 bars, let's say. There's no problems with the sync whatsoever. And then from there, I just copy and paste, and then I can do all my mixing right there. As you see, I have my whole beat right here. It's all put together, and I just copy and paste like that. So that way it's a lot faster. So just keep that in mind when you're tracking out. You could do it my way, or you could try to do it the long way with recording the whole song from your MPC. So keep that in mind. So hopefully it works for you. If you got any questions, just post below. Make sure you click on like and subscribe and all that good stuff. And I'll see if I can answer your questions. And that's it. All right. Now go make some beats.